Welcome back to another video. If you're new to my channel, welcome. For this video, I'm going to be making a super cute chocolate donut nail set. So I'm starting off with this extended press-on nail. I've used this a few other times, like I mentioned in my previous video, and I did make a playlist of all the times that I've done this method. So if you're interested in seeing how I got to this point, then check out some of those other videos in the playlist. But I just went ahead and put the nail tips together, and now I'm just going in with my base coat gel. So I'm going to go in with 3 coats of that, and I'm going to cure in between each coat. For my featured comment, I wanted to say thank you so much to Stephen Clark. It's funny because every time my family sees comments where people are saying that they like my voice, they just think it's so hilarious. But I really do appreciate your comment, and thanks for almost being first. Now that I have my base layers down, I'm going to go in and do my nail design. So I'm taking this new color, which is from a pine gel polish kit, and I'm going to do 2 coats of that on the middle finger and the pointer finger, and I'm going to cure in between each coat. Once I have that cured, I'm now going to go in with this gel polish from Aloe Vera, and I'm going to mix this with some black to make a chocolate brown color. If you missed my upload where I showed this gel polish kit and all of the other colors that came with it, be sure to go check that out. I'll leave that video in the cards. But yeah, I wanted to make a nice dark chocolate brown, so I'm just mixing in a little bit of black, and I'm just going to mix that together, and then I'm going to be applying that on the pinky and the thumb. Once I mixed it and applied it to the nail, I realized that it was coming up like almost a jelly color, which was cute, but it wasn't the look that I was going for. And I think it's because that black gel polish, which is from AliExpress, it comes up kind of like a jelly color unless you build it up with almost 3 coats. So I usually go in with multiple coats of that color. So I went in with this first coat, and I was thinking like, okay, I'll just be able to go back in and build it up and it'll look a little bit better. But I actually ended up going back and mixing the color again, and instead of using the black gel polish, I used the black gel pot from that 36 color gel pot kit that I always use, and it turned out much better. So yeah, you'll see me do that in a minute, but I'm just going to do the 2 coats on the pinky and the thumb. Now I'm going to go in and do my marble design. So I'm putting a layer of base coat down. I'm not going to cure that in the lamp. I'm going to put the other gel polishes into the uncured base coat. But I absolutely love the way that this nail turned out. I've seen a few other people do like the brown marble with like the chocolate brown and nude, and it always gave me like a coffee or cappuccino vibe. So I added that lighter shade of brown from the aloe vera kit without it being mixed with the black, and it really showed up almost like a caramel swirl. So I was loving it. It just turned out so pretty. So I just went in and made sure that it was all the way to the edges, all the way around. And then I also tried to use my brush to kind of wipe down the sides a little bit. I didn't want to use my finger. I'm still waiting for my gloves to get here. So yeah, I just wiped down the sides a little bit, and then I cured that in the lamp. So now I'm going on to the pointer finger, which I wanted to do like a chocolate drip. So I'm just going in and applying that around the cuticle area, and then I'm going to take a small dotting tool to kind of draw on the little drips. So that's how the first coat turned out, and I just went in and added another layer just so that it could be nice and dark. But once I do that, I'm then going to go on to create my donuts. So to create my donuts, I used this cocoa brown poly gel, and I just showed that was like the little trial one that I did, and I really loved the way that it turned out, and it was super easy to do. So you basically want to put a little glob of the poly gel on the nail, and then I just got my brush and put some slip solution on it, and then I'm just kind of patting it down a little bit, and I'm just going to go around the sides and try to get a nice circular shape. It doesn't have to be perfect, but I just took my time and worked with it and just tried to round it out as much as possible but still keep it kind of thick. And I just was guesstimating with as much poly gel that I put. It's not really a science to it. I just put it on there, and I just wanted it to be like one was a little bit larger than the other one. So I just went in and continued to move it around, and then I'm going to go in with a small dotting tool, and I'm going to cover that in slip solution, and then I'm going to try to poke it right in the center of the circle and kind of move it around a little bit so that I can create my donut hole. And once I go in and do this, I'm then going to go back around the nails, because going into the center, it kind of makes it lose its shape a little bit on the edges. So I just went back in and kind of smoothed it out around the sides. But once I had it how I wanted, I just went ahead and popped it in the lamp and allowed it to fully cure. So the longer you let it sit, the hole will try to close up a little bit. So you just want to go back in with the dotting tool and spread it out again. And then once I had it exactly how I wanted it, I cured it in the lamp. And now I'm going in with that chocolate brown color again, and I'm just putting it over it like a chocolate glaze. And I went in and did one coat of that. I cured it in the lamp. And then I went back in with the same small dotting tool and some white gel polish to do like a white chocolate drizzle on one of the donuts, and then you're going to see me go in with the second coat of the same chocolate color on the other donut. Once I had that exactly how I wanted it, I went ahead and cured that in the lamp. And now I'm going to go in and do my donuts on the thumb. So I had an idea to do a huge donut, and I wanted it to look like it had a bite taken out of it, but it really didn't turn out how I wanted it to. So I ended up fixing it back to just be a full donut. But I decided to leave that in just so y'all can see the mistakes that I made. I tried to go in with a nail tip and kind of just carve out that little section, but of course I'm using poly gel. I've seen people do stuff like that using acrylic, but I guess they were doing it once the acrylic had already started to set a little bit. So once you take out whatever section, it still kind of holds the rest of the shape. But of course the poly gel isn't cured, so it was kind of getting stringy, and yeah, it was just a mess. So I ended up going back in and reshaping it, and then I also did two smaller donuts on the nail. So I'll just let y'all watch that and then I'll check back in. So this is how the set turned out. I'm going in now with some matte top coat on the two dark chocolate nails. So I'm putting it all around the donuts, and then I am going to go in and top coat the donuts also and make sure I get the edges. Since they are made out of poly gel, they will have a sticky layer, so you definitely want to cover that. But I wanted those to be glossy, so I just went over those with the top coat. And then once I cure that in the lamp, I am going to apply the nails. So I'm just going to go in and apply some peel off base coat to my natural nails first, because I don't plan on wearing these nails for long. But of course, if you did plan on wearing your nails and you wanted your press-ons to last for about 2 or 3 weeks, then you would want to go in and lightly file the shine off of your natural nail and then go in with some dehydrator and primer. I'll leave a link in the description box to the dehydrator and primer that I typically use from the brand Mia Secret. But yeah, this is me going back in and top coating over those donuts so that they'll be nice and glazed. And then I just took them off of the nail stand. But yeah, I would definitely be interested in hearing what y'all think about the 3D nail art that I created. Is this set something that you will wear, or is it a little bit too extra? I'm just going in with some McCart nail glue to apply that also, as always. But yeah, I really do love the way that this set turned out, and I've been thinking about it for a while. I just wanted to wait until it was like closer to fall, since this color is really popular in the fall. But yeah, I think it's super cute. So of course, if you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, and also subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. Go ahead and press that notification bell so that you'll be notified when I upload, and I'll see y'all in the next video. Bye.